Hi, dear student. Today we are going to start for the next topic, that it is systematics of living organism. Now, what is systematics? Systematics is the study of kinds and diversity of organisms and their comparative as well as evolutionary relationship. In the case of systematic study of kinds and diversity of organism is performed on the scientific basis. Around us, number of different kinds of organisms are present, and from a very far time humans have an immense use of all that living organisms present around his ecosystem. So in his ecosystem, whatever the plants, animals and various kinds of organisms are present are used by the human being. But to use those animals in a proper way, to use those organisms in a proper way, maybe microorganisms are engaged in a fermentation industry. Maybe the animals, some act as an parasites also. Maybe the plants are used in a medicinal purpose. To have an data, to have an information about all those various kinds of plants, animals and microorganisms, we should have the scientific study of all those organisms to classify them in a proper way. To differentiate the plant from the animal, we go for a comparison in between them. Like, animals are heterotrophic, plants are autotrophic. Some animals can move from one place to another place, but the plants, these are immovable. They are not going to show the locomotion. Plant shows a movement but does not show a locomotion. Animal have an definite growth. Plant have indefinite growth in the relation of some part like root tip and shoot tip. So this is a comparative study. And when we want to discuss about the evolutionary relationship, evolution, the branch of biology which deals with the study of present organism in the relation of their ancestors. So in evolutionary relationship, we are going to check whether the monkey, whether the apes have a relationship with the human or not. In this way, if we go for study the organism, it is easy for us to arrange, it is easy for us to remember, it is easy for us to classify all those diverse group of the plant as well as the animals or living organisms. So that it is a systematics, is the study of kinds and diversity of organisms and their comparative and evolutionary relationship. The term systematics was firstly used by the scientist G. Simpson in 1961. Then, taxonomy. What is taxonomy? Taxonomy is a word which came from the Greek language. Taxis meaning arrangement and nomos meaning law or a particular system or a rule of arranging those organisms in a particular way. Taxonomy means classification which following certain rules and principles. On the basis of those rules, we are going to make differentiation in between the plants, in between the animals or fungi or protista or monerans. That means here we have a classification of all living organism in five different kingdoms. The term taxonomy was first introduced by the scientist A.P.D. Kandel. Next, classification. What is classification? Classification is the arrangement of organisms or groups of organisms in a distinct categories in accordance with a particular and well-established plan. As we have discussed firstly in systematics also, same way here in classification, we are going to arrange the organism in a different groups or in a different categories. According to what? According to the particular or well-established plan. Like, the classification are of three different types over here. On the basis of that, we got a clear-cut idea about the classification. And what is that classification? The differentiation of those organisms is depends upon similarities and dissimilarities among them. Like, we have discussed the kingdom Animalia and kingdom Plantae. They show some similar things as, what are the similarity? Each and every organism is formed with the help of a cell. So this is a similar thing. Another, each and every organism shows the genetic material in the form of DNA. Or, all the living organism, they shows a nucleic acid in the form of a DNA as well as RNA. All living organism shows a metabolism. All living organism shows a reflex action or responsiveness. All living organism, they have a process of metabolism. That means, in all those five kingdoms, these things are similar. But the similar things are not helpful for us to classify the animals. Instead of similarity, we should know about the differences amongst them. Then, as the differences we have studied, we have taken plant shows differences from the animal. Plants are dissimilar from the animals. Fungus, they show a similarity like that of the plant, but have number of the dissimilarities from the plant. Same way about the monera. Same way about the protista also. This is about classification. Here the types of classification. First one, artificial classification. In artificial classification, you can observe the process of classification is based on few and easily observable and non-evolutionary features, such as habit of the animal, habit of the organisms. If they are residing in a different habit, then we are going to say are different in their classification. We are going to make a different group. Like, all are mammal, but see, a whale is present in water, bat are present in air, human are present on land. All are mammal, but we can't classify them on the basis of a habitat. Okay, it makes a Cows. It makes a difficulty to bring all those animals in the same group. Color. That buffalo have an black color, bat have an black color. So we can't bring them in one group. Horse have an same color. And some fish have an same color. Some bird and horse have a same color but are not belongs to the same category. That means artificial classification is not helpful to make an a concrete group of a classification. That it is based. Previously the system is used but it is not useful, mind it. Then what is an artificial example of artificial classification? In which you can take an Linnaeus, Carlos Linnaeus. Carlos Linnaeus perform an classification irrespective of their affinity, irrespective of their relationship amongst them, maybe evolutionary relationship, maybe the relationship related to their characteristics feature. Only we are going to classify the animals on the basis of habitat, color and their form. So it not working properly on the scientific level. Then second, natural system of classification. This natural system of classification is based on objectively significant rather than being selected for convenience like artificial system of classification. Here in natural system of classification, convenience related to the visible things are not followed. In natural system of classification, objectively the group of organisms are prepared. While making the group of organisms, the objects or the things are taken into the consideration, which helpful to classify the animals or organisms, like Bentham and Hooker system of classification. And third way of classification, that it is a phylogenetic classification. This phylogenetic classification, it is based on common evolutionary descent. Evolution, the stepwise gradual changes takes place into the past organism due to the formation of present day complex form is called as an evolution. So in the process of evolution, slow, continuous, gradual, stepwise changes are takes place into the past organism, into the previous organism, leads to the formation of a present day form is called as evolution. Evolutionary descent, descendants, that means those are get evolved from the common ancestor. Now common evolutionary descent, you can take an example. We are going to say all the mammals are get evolved from the common ant eater ancestor. Like in the relation of a human being, you can take an example. Common ant eater primates, they lead to the formation or they have a common evolutionary descent like lemurs, tarsiers, old world monkeys, new world monkeys, hominoids. That means all are get evolved from the same common ancestor. Forget about that much detail. We can take one example over here about the phylogenetic classification as Engler and Prandtl's classification. And here you can take an example All that bacteria, archaea, and eukarya are get evolved from the common ancestor. Here, it gave us an idea. All are evolved from common ancestor. Same basis is there. They have the same evolutionary history. These are the ancestor from which bacteria are get evolved, then archaea are get evolved, and eukarya are get evolved. So this is about phylogenetic classification. So these are the three different forms of classification, like artificial, natural, and phylogenetic. By using all those forms, one can classify the organism in respective group. This is not so only one system is followed while classifying the organism. If all those systems are followed properly, then it is easy for us to classify the organism in different groups. It's all for today's lecture. Thank you.